will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it.
Our Coral Ridge family is made up of thousands of people around the country who care deeply about our ministry. Orville and Ruth Marilat are two such people who have dedicated their entire married lives to spreading the good news of Jesus Christ. In fact, this week, Orville and Ruth will celebrate their 51st wedding anniversary. I praise God for what He has done through this very special couple and the impact that their amazing story has had on me personally and so many others who love them and who have benefited from their ministry.
In the small rural town of Adrian, Michigan, just a few hours outside Detroit, live Orville and Ruth Marilat. He is the founder of Marilat Industries, one of the largest manufacturers of kitchen and bathroom cabinets with 11 plants nationwide. A stroke 6 years ago forced him to sell the company, but has not slowed him down from doing the things he loves best. And although Marilat Industries is a very large company today, it came from some very humble beginnings. During World War II, Orville Marilat served as a ship's carpenter and earned $151 a month. He kept only one of those dollars and sent the other $150 home to his bride, Ruth. In 1945, their savings totaled just over $8,200. That was enough to open the doors to the Marilat Woodworking Company. Through all their growth as a company, the Marilats knew the importance of keeping God and His principles first in their lives. This has been evident as they have held close to the principle of tithing back to God.
It is the natural thing to do, is to give your tithe, and then when you can, you know, give gifts beyond that, is really the things that blesses.
You're really not giving until you give more than 10%. The 10% belongs to the Lord, so it isn't yours. And our goal was to go beyond that, way beyond that.
I can say that there's nothing in this world worth holding on to compared to the blessings that the Lord can give you.
Orville and Ruth have never forgotten their humble beginnings. In an effort to give back to the community, which has helped make their company so successful, they have donated millions of dollars to their church, education, and recreation. Their strong support of Christian education and ideals led the Marilats to build the Lenawee Christian Elementary, Junior, and Senior High Schools. Adjacent to the schools, they built the Christian Family Center, a multi-purpose recreational facility. This is spokesman Ed Gore.
Well, these are unusual compassionate people, and they have done this to support their community. It's a blessing. I think the members appreciate a facility where they can bring their children. We cater to the families, so we expect the children to be here.
It really gives you a great feeling because you could see there are so many needs out there and that you're able to help a lot of people. And when these people come back and they tell you, you know, how much they appreciated, you know, what you did for them, that it really makes it worthwhile.
From the simple one-room woodworking shop to the worldwide corporation, Orville and Ruth Marilott have felt the joy that comes when they put into practice the principle of tithing and giving, and how that giving benefits both God and His people.
Hello, everyone. This is James Dobson. Ever since I visited your wonderful facilities there in Adrian last year, I've had an intense love and respect for the Marilott family, and especially my brother and sister, Orville and Ruth. You all have earned the respect and admiration of all of us because of your integrity and because of the way you've lived your lives. In this day of temporary short-term commitments, you've shown us that love for a lifetime is still possible, and that a dedication to Jesus Christ does make a difference, the difference in the quality of family life.
The Marilott Center for the Arts is the culmination of an effort which began years ago, and it exists today largely due to the generous leadership of Dr. Orville and Ruth Marilott. Orville and Ruth, you are leaders worthy of respect and high praise. Because of your willingness to look to the future needs and demands of Christian higher education, Huntington College is now crossing this threshold into the future.
So there is the individual commitment by the part of parents themselves. There must be the obligation of government not to harm. But there is a role for third parties as well. Others in our society can, by their actions, by their generosity, by their deeds, show us their commitment to the family. And so we end up where we are today at this important dedication. By this act of generosity, by this act of all of us coming together here, a community says the family matters. The family is important. We stand for the family. So that when the question is asked anywhere in the United States, who stands up for the family? Who speaks for the family? There is now in this great country at least one place that we can point to and say without any hesitation, unequivocally, here is a place that stands up for the family. Here is a place that speaks for the family.
Thank you for giving to the Lord. I am a life that was changed.
One by one they came, far as the eye could see. Each life somehow touched by your generosity. Little things that you had done, sacrifices made, unnoticed on the earth, in heaven now proclaimed. I know up in heaven, you're not supposed to cry. But I am almost sure there were tears in your eyes as Jesus took your hand and you stood before. for the Lord. He said, my child, look around you, for great is your reward. Thank you for giving to the Lord. For I am a life that was changed.
Yeah.